teach our kids the importance of love. Because if you teach them love, the joints won't be so important.
He was humble. He was a very humble young man who just wanted his actions to speak for him. He didn't have a lot of words. He just always wanted to give back to the community. He told me that he was young and he wanted to do things for young people, and he just enjoyed doing it. He was just humble. That's the word.
You know, it breaks my heart that it takes something like this for us to come together.
Okay.
What are we doing in the community every day? I'm very passionate about kids, y'all, so I'm sorry if I get a little emotional.
We do a lot of stop the violence in the community, and he was doing a cookout for a friend who had lost his life, and I was truly interested in him. I've been knowing his dad all my life, Mario, and I was just interested in how he was just remembering his friend, and I thought that was a great young man to do something like that.
When I turned the corner, I didn't think it. You know, I thought maybe I'd run into 10 or 15 people, you know, and we'll stand around and we'll just, but when I turned that corner, it's like, what in the world, you know, because I didn't think he had such an impact, you know, so young, you know, just 18, you know, and I just didn't know he had done so much. I watched him close as anybody, but, you know, I know he's a loving kid, I know he's a kind kid, I know he was a respectful kid, and I see that's what people fell in love with, you know.
I've been in these shoes before, and I know how it feels to lose a brother and a friend and a cousin to violence, and it has to be stopped.
As I said, I was transferred from North Alabama to Decatur, and when you move somewhere your senior year, it's kind of difficult and hard, but when you have people like Jakell that greet you and comfort you and telling you, oh, it's not that bad, Opelika's really not that bad, it's very comforting and it helps you, and that's the way I remember it.
Or another day, but Lord, we need you. Lord, we need you right away.
So when that challenge comes with words, walk away. When that challenge comes with words, trust me, it ain't just words. Walk away. Because you just imagine a 150, you look behind you, those kids, 150. You think he gonna touch Leonard? You think he gonna put his hands on Devontae Leonard? His hands? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. He's going for the kill. And that's what happened to my son.
Now this thing had hit home. It's hit home and it's hit me right dead center. I got something going on right here. I don't even know what it is, but it's something poking me right here. So, you know, I'm glad, I'm happy to be here, and I know with all your prayers, I'll be just fine, and so will my family. Thank y'all for coming.